We're joined today by Steve Oldham, the president and CEO of SureWest Communications. Started out as Roseville Telephone how many years ago?
94 years ago, Kelly.
94 years ago.
Yes.
And now you're SureWest, and now for the first time you've expanded outside of Northern California, right?
That's correct. Just February of this year, we bought Everest Broadband in Kansas City, Kansas.
Kansas City, Kansas, not Missouri. But
that's correct. We actually have a few customers in Missouri, but most of them are in Kansas City, Kansas.
And why did you choose there to make your first purchase out of what had been kind of your bailiwick?
We actually looked at several properties around the country, including California, but we wanted to find the network that had the most advanced capability of any in the area they serve. Everest fit that bill. The second thing was Everest is pretty much self-contained. They had 185 employees. They've been running the business for 7 years. They can run it without a lot of input from us, and it's a very profitable business.
So where do you go from here? I mean, 10 years from now, what would you like to see SureWest's geographical footprint look like? Because up until this past February, it was just Northern California.
That's correct. We want to continue to expand in Northern California. The slowdown in the real estate market affects the rate with which we can expand here. But if we find other more diverse geographic locations that have less impact from real estate cycles, we can continue our expansion plan outside of just Northern California. So we continue to look for those properties.
So how do you compete? I mean, you are up against global players, Comcast, AT&T, Dish, DirecTV. How do you, as a little guy, compete?
Two keys to this thing. The first one is the most advanced network deployed wherever we serve. So no one else can deliver the information as fast or with as high a quality. The second thing is customer service. We regularly do surveys about our customers and our competitors' customers, and we strive really to be number one, and we have been for quite a while.
What is your secret to dealing with people? Because I know that a lot of folks who are at SureWest have been there for a long time.
Well, for us, the big thing is to explain to them exactly what's going on in the industry. The evolution in the industry has been profound. They have to constantly be told and given reassurance that the growth pattern we're on really is going to supplant the changes that have taken place in the industry over the last 10 years.
So let's start off with a few questions here. What was your first summer job growing up?
Actually, my father owned a grocery store, and so all of us, there were four boys in my family, all worked at the grocery store. And we worked there actually for many years.
And where was that?
Salt Lake City, Utah.
And what was the strangest job you ever had to do?
Well, I was in the Army. And when I was in the Army, they come up with a number of different jobs. I was in the 82nd Airborne for a while, and I was in the Aleutian Islands and Shimmio, almost the end island on the Aleutian chain. Mm-hmm. And spent a year up there doing electronic monitoring of the Soviet Union. That was a very interesting job.
I bet it was. What is the one piece of technology you could not live without?
Well, I guess for me, it's my computer. Almost all my communications are on that. We spend a good deal of time with our folks in Kansas City. It's a very efficient way, email and other kinds of document transmission over the computer.
Internet. Webcasting, too?
Webcasting, internet, sure.
Do you? Wow.
And we want to see that grow.
Let me see. What else do we have? What's your favorite business publication? There's so many of them out there now.
Well, I regularly read things like Forbes, a lot of trade publications. Oh, okay. And they're a little boring to most people, cable TV and those sorts of things. But it's very important for us to stay attuned to what our competitors are doing.
Did you have a role model or mentor as you were coming up through the business?
Really, Brian Strom, who was my predecessor, was very skilled at looking at trends and recognizing these trends. And Brian did a great job. I was on the board before I became the CEO. And Brian did a great job of leading this company to the ability to make the change it needed to do.
Most expensive business lesson you ever learned?
Oh, gosh. And I was in the electric utility business for 27 years in the Western Power Crisis in 99, 2000, 2001.
Oh, yeah.
Clearly, we learned about what happens when the long-time regulation paradigm breaks down in the midst of escalating energy prices. And it cost literally the state of California and Nevada billions of dollars prior to getting the regulation back into place to assure no abuses were taking place.
And in many ways, the mortgage business is going through something similar now.
I would say it's very similar now. A little bit of zeal in the industry, a little bit of lack of regulation and restructuring was going on the last few years, and I think it got way out ahead of the ability to manage it.
Work-life balance. What is your work-life balance, and what would you like it to be? In other words, if you said it was 80-20, work versus the other parts of your life, what is it, what should it be?
Well, it probably is about 80-20, work versus the other parts of our life. My wife and I are both striving very much. We have two daughters in college, and we're striving very much to get a little bit more time on our own.
Yeah.
We have a boat that we leave down in Santa Cruz and try to get down there as often as possible. We love the Monterey Bay area.
That's great. Steve, great to have you in.
Thank you, Kelly.
I do appreciate your time and wish you continued success with SureWest.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Steve Oldham, President and CEO of SureWest Communications.